We live in the age of computers and the internet, but some of the people who could most benefit from them have been shut out because of their disabilities. Now, new technology is being tested in Ottawa that allows people with disabilities to nose their way around the net. Steve Fisher reports.
Linda Baker has multiple sclerosis. She works hard to be as independent as she can, even using her head to operate her wheelchair.
Enable mouse again, and then put your nose on the middle.
Now Linda, along with 12 other patients at St. Vincent Hospital, are test driving new technology, a device called a nose, a combination of mouse and nose.
And what it would do first, it would detect your face, and then it would try to detect your nose.
The Elizabeth Breyer Research Institute and the National Research Council are developing the nose as a way for people like Linda to operate a computer hands-free. Turn your nose one way, the image will follow. A pause and tilt down works the same as a click of the mouse. Users can even access an on-screen keyboard.
Computers are so integrated into our lives these days that it's really important for people to, with disabilities to be able to access the computer and use it to its full advantage.
Linda used to be on the internet regularly until she lost mobility in her arms. Now she hopes to be able to reconnect with her friends and others who have MS.
I have rare kind of disease, and it's kind of nice to talk to somebody else who has the same kind, just to see what they're doing, how they're making out.
With the help of feedback from patients and staff here, the National Research Council plans to continue to fine-tune this product through the fall. They hope to eventually find a private company that can take it to market. Steve Fisher, CBC News, Ottawa.